We're back revealing your most embarrassing health problems that got you caught red-handed. Next up is Lisa.
I have never confessed my most embarrassing day ever until now. I still can't believe it happened. I was really excited to get one of the biggest speaking engagements of my career. So, of course, I was planning and preparing for weeks. I wanted to also look good, so I decided to get these individual lashes that my friends were bragging about. I figured, you know, try it out. Can't hurt. So I go in there, and they started doing my lashes one by one. I'm laying back. I'm being pampered. And when it was over, she turned me to the mirror, and I was like, boom! My eyes popped. You couldn't tell me I wasn't cute. When I got home, I laid down, and eventually I fell asleep. So my alarm goes off the next day, and I get up, and all of a sudden, panic hits. My eyelids were literally glued shut. So I jumped out of bed in the dark, and I'm fumbling, and I'm banging my knee and hitting my elbow, fling around trying to find my phone. And then I finally found it and called my sister, and she said, you've got to go to the hospital now. They rushed me in there and they washed my eyes out. And once I was able to open my eyes, I knew I'm not making that speaking engagement. And I was too embarrassed to tell them the real reason. So I just lied and said it was an eye infection.
I love that. Did you ever tell folks what really happened?
Dr. Oz, of course I didn't. I was embarrassed. The only person I told was my sister because I knew I needed her to take me to the hospital. But can you imagine, Dr. Oz, calling the engagement saying, I've got to cancel because my eyelids are stuck together? Like, who in the world would believe that? People lie every day about why they're not going to work. So I just told them I had an infection. But of course I didn't tell anybody. I was too ashamed.
So have you ever gone back and got your eyelashes done again?
Dr. Oz, why did you ask me that question?
Well, I'm curious if you try it again. I don't know what happened.
I love the lashes, but I was too afraid to ever do it again. I've been tempted, but I'm too afraid.
So let me bring in an expert. This dermatologist, Ellen Marmer, is joining us. So what the heck happened to Lisa's eyes?
Please tell me.
Oh, Lisa, you poor thing. Everybody wants glamorous eyelashes.
Yes.
Absolutely, right? I mean, we do. And yours look great anyway. I'm glad that you still have eyelashes.
Really?
Absolutely.
They look great.
Yes, they do. They're there. So the adhesive.
They're there.
The adhesive can actually rip out the eyelashes, and it sounds like
and
that might
did.
Have happened
and
to
actually,
you.
And actually, when once I left the hospital, they cleaned everything out. I had no lashes left. I said, now I'm going blind, and I have bald lashes.
Nightmare. But the problem is when we use too much of the adhesive, it sounds like the person who put yours on used way too much. And when it hits the watery, moist area of the eyelid, it turns hard, and that seeped down to the lower eyelid and literally sealed your eyes shut.
Oh, because I was like, I went from beauty to the beast?
Beauty to beast. And the other thing that can happen when you use too much of the glue is that glue is formaldehyde. And do you remember Brazilian hair straightening and people were getting these terrible reactions?
Right.
You're getting like a mini reaction, allergic reaction on the eyelid.
So come show us how to do this safely. This will be useful for everybody, I think. Come on over
here. Okay, thanks.
So we made a little demonstration of what your eyes look like before you had this all done. So go ahead, Ellen, explain to us what makes, you know, a smart way. Ellen, what's standing here?
Okay, great. So what happened was here is that, I mean, this is your normal eyelash, right? So this is your little hair follicle and your nice little eyelash, and this is our skin here. Mm-hmm. And so the ideal place to put the eyelashes is between your normal eyelashes.
Right.
But some people, when they're in a big rush, or if you have an amateur extensionist, they just swipe on the glue all back and forth, all over the place here, and then they press on the eyelashes. That's the wrong way of going about it. What you want to do is snip your Q-tip in half and just put a little dot of it on the Q-tip here and then use your Q-tip. Let me see if I'm getting enough here. Use your Q-tip on the lash extension. See that?
Yeah.
Then you've got your glue and we're sticking it between the eyelashes, okay? And it should stick right on there. And you just do it one by one by one, which is hard for some of us, right, to actually be that refined, but just aim, and the idea here is use less glue and just take a little bit more time so that you don't cause an allergic reaction.
If you don't want to use fake lashes, what other options do you have?
You know what we all have at home? We have our Lush's olive oil. Okay. It doesn't matter how expensive or not it is, but this is a really good natural way. And, yeah, you just rub your finger in, and you moisturize Your eyelash area.
Now, is it going to thicken it or make them grow longer?
It's going to protect your skin, and it's going to allow your own lashes to grow and stay in there longer.
Oh.
Our hair falls out when we get stressed, right?
Okay.
And eyelash extenders and mascara, if you don't take care of the area, that stress is going to cause all your natural eyelashes to fall out, and yours got ripped out.
Oh, my God.
There you are.
Thank you for sharing your story.
Up next, some of our audience is getting caught red-handed and have no idea. Just watch.